Hi, my name's Seth and I'm the manager of horticulture here at the Peggy Notebaert Nature Museum. Today, we're going to take a look at prairie flowers in the composite family. Let's see what we have growing here on the grounds. A composite flower may look like a single flower, but it's actually composed of many, many flowers held together in a receptacle. Many flowers in a prairie have this basic shape, a daisy-like flower. And then many of them are yellow, and so they become a little hard to tell apart. But these are all very important flowers because they're prominent sources of nectar for various pollinators, including butterflies and bees. Let's take a closer look at a composite flower. This is a compass flower cut in half. And as you can see, there's a lot going on here. All of these separate parts are actually tiny flowers, complete in themselves. On the outside, you have what are called the ray flowers. Here's an example. Oop, fell apart. This is a complete flower, but it looks like just one petal. In the inside are what we have called the disc flowers. The ones here in the center have not opened yet. Here, the ones around the outer edge have. Sometimes in composites, there are only ray flowers or there are only disc flowers. This is an example of a classic composite flower with both. Compass plant is just one of many composite flowers you can find on the prairie. Right now, we have rosin weed, a plant in the same genus as compass plant, false sunflower, and over here we have gray-headed coleflower. Come down to the museum and see what you can find.